my God. Another boring day of school is in our hands.
Yeah, I don't feel like going through another painful day of boring work and listening to the teacher giving her boring lessons.
Yeah. But you won't have to worry about all that today, because I heard that the teacher is not here today.
Really? Amazing. Now we won't have to worry about work today.
Yeah. And we can pretty much do whatever we want today.
Yeah!
Today will be a great day, knowing that there is no teacher today.
Actually, I hear that we have a substitute teacher today.
What? You can't be serious.
So now we are stuck with some stupid teacher, right?
Yeah, I guess so. This is gonna suck.
Oh my God, you guys need to get over it. And for the record, you should actually pay attention in class anyways instead of being the menaces to society you are.
Shut the hell up, you freak.
Hello, class. I'm Mr. Simba, and I will be filling in for Mrs. Liberty, since she is not here today. Anyways, today we will be reading some poems. And after that, you will all be answering questions based on those poems. We will start with this poem called The Pobble Who Has No Toes by Edward Lear. The pobble who has no toes had once as many as we. When they said someday you may lose them all. He replied fish, fiddle-de-dee. And his Aunt Jabiska made him drink lavender water tinted with pink.
I'm already
for she said the
tear.
World in general
I
knows
know,
there's
right?
nothing so
I
good for
feel
a pobble's
like
toes. Coin bro, would you like to read this poem in front of the entire class?
What? No. Why would you ask?
Well, it's because you seem more interested in having a full-blown conversation with your friends. So, how about you read this poem in front of the class since you have a lot to say?
Look, sucker. I said I don't want to read the poet.
Hey. Coin bro, you better watch your mouth.
Ugh. Whatever you say.
You know, I am already about to leave this classroom and hang out with Buzzer.
Me too. In fact, I think we all are.
You took the words right out of my mouth. I'm pretty sure I said that I shouldn't be hearing any talking. I'm trying to read some poems, and I'm pretty sure no one asked for your stupid opinion.
Yeah. I agree with Shuriken bro. Shut your mouth, and stay out of our business. You stupid loser.
Shuriken bro and wrench bro. I told you and your friends to watch your mouth. Now, let's get back to the poem. Also, when my mouth is moving, that means I shouldn't hear talking.
Oh please. Aside from talking, your mouth probably also moves when you're trying to chase your tail. Also, your tail also talks when you are trying to sleep in bed.
Oh my God, coin bro. That was incredibly savage. Ha 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 ha.
Yeah, coin bro. I have a lot of respect for you for that insult.
Right. You guys are really starting to tip me off. If you keep this up, I'm sending the six of you to the principal's office. Now please stop it.
No. How about you eat my poop?
Cyborg bro. I said stop it with that.
Oh. You thought I was joking, right? No, I wasn't. Eat my poop. And lick the plate good and clean.
Oh my God, that is absolutely disgusting. I can't look at it at all.
Oh my gosh. That was just gross. Mr. Simba, can I please use the bathroom? I feel like I'm about to throw up.
Of course. Go ahead, Daniel.
No. Daniel, you may not use the bathroom.
Excuse me? Coin bro, I wasn't talking to you. I was talking to Daniel. I don't care who you were talking to. Daniel is not allowed to use the bathroom. And just who do you think you are to say that Daniel can't use the bathroom? To my knowledge, you are not the teacher. Daniel, you can go ahead and use the bathroom.
Thank you, Mr. Simba.
King Simba of the so-called Pride Lands. You shouldn't even be talking. I mean, you are not a real teacher either. You're a substitute teacher.
Excuse me? Did you just call me by my full name?
Yes, I did. What the hell are you gonna do about it?
Yeah!
Actually, what you should do is go back to the zoo where you freaking belong.
Yeah, you stupid sucker. And your stupid slacks of kids, Kiara and Ken, also belong in the zoo. Hey! Don't you ever speak about my kids like that. You hear me? Now this is your last chance. Start behaving right now, or else I will send all six of you to the principal's office.
Let me tell you something, you loser. You are a stupid freaking dumb substitute teacher. And your kids are brats, and you freaking know it.
Yeah. I agree with Coinbro. You're a waste of time, and you're also a waste of valuable oxygen. You freaking sucker.
Oh crap. It looks like he's about to blow a fuse.
Yeah!
He's about to blow his top off. Ha.
That's it. I have had enough of your behaviors. You all are getting a one-way ticket to the principal's office. Let's go there right now.
Sucker, we are not going to the principal's office. And you can't make us.
I said, let's go to the principal's office right now.
Well, I am at a loss for words right now. Coin bro, keyboard bro, bench bro, shirt bro, chomp bro, and baseball bro. I can't believe you all would go as far as to disrespect your substitute teacher like that. I mean, all of the things you said and did to him was absolutely horrible and inexcusable.
Principal Jeffy, we are so sorry for what we did. We promise it won't happen again.
No. Don't you give me that I'm sorry crap. You all say that you're sorry and yet you still continue to cause trouble. So basically, you show no remorse for your actions. However, I think at this point your tiny brains are unable to come to the realization.
Hey! Our brain!
Silence! But anyways, your behaviors were absolutely unacceptable. As a punishment for all your actions today, you all are hereby suspended for 5 months. All six of you, go home right now.
Coin bro, cyborg bro, wrench bro, shuriken bro, chomp bro, and baseball bro. I can't believe you guys disrespected your substitute teacher. That's it. You all are grounded for 7 months. Go to your rooms right now.
Why?